These matches seem to get better and better every week. How you doing? I'm Jack Buck, and you're just in time for Top Star Bowling. We only have a moment. We've got a perfect seat for you here at the Marlboro Lanes. Come on along. Welcome once again to Top Star Bowling from the Marlboro Lanes. We're located in the village of Marlboro, just outside the city of St. Louis on Route 66. And we're at the gateway to the west for another fine bowling session. And we'll be introducing in just a moment a bowler who'll be back for the fifth consecutive time on Top Star Bowling. Prior to that introduction, a bit about the show. It is a three-game match, $1,000 to the winner, $500 to the loser. Total pins count. The winner stays around to come back again. In addition, they're shooting for additional prize money provided by King Louis Shirts of $1,500 for the high series and $1,000 for the high game. And our defending champion this week has a crack at that additional $2,500. I know that you've grown accustomed to his face along about this time. He's from Detroit, Billy Golembiewski. Well, good to see you once again.
Nice to be back here.
How are things in Detroit, all right?
Very good.
And you have a fellow from Milwaukee to take you out.
Al Savas.
Mm-hmm. Good
right
one,
there.
Huh?
He sure is.
Tough bowler, huh? This fellow is one of the great team bowlers and quite a star in his own right with 9 sanctioned 300 games. He's from Milwaukee, Al Savas. Albert, good to see you.
Jack, nice to see you again.
Savas. We're going to get rid of this guy. We're not against you, but we don't have anything to talk about anymore up here with him.
Well, we should have a pretty interesting match. We've got a red jewel and a blue jewel and a Greek and a Polski, so...
Anything can happen, huh?
Anything can happen.
We'll let it go at that, the handshake, and we'll be underway.
Okay.
Billy G and Al Savas. Should be a good one. You'll be glad that you tuned in. We're all set to go on Top Star Bowling. Billy G won the toss, and he elected to lead off. Wants to give Al Savas something to shoot at. You talk about contrasting styles, you're going to see it here. The only thing that may not be in contrast is the strikes that these two will throw. We'll watch Al Savas now, and then I'll be introducing my partner at the microphone. Al from Milwaukee, lived in St. Louis for a while, back in his old hometown now. See how far in he is? And right into the pocket, and the strike is. Now, you saw that Golembiewski is playing way outside, and Al Savas is playing way inside. Now, oftentimes, we talk about in and out, and perhaps it hasn't been apparent to you, but I'm certain it will be on this Top Star Bowling edition. Alongside me is Jerome Whitey Harris, a member of the Brunswick Advisory Staff of Champions, well-known name in bowling here in the States, and he's traveled around the world to help the sport of bowling. You'll be hearing from him right after Savas gets a 9 count. He took away the drama. I thought I was going to be able to say a double, Whitey.
Well, you described it right, Jack. If there's ever two bowlers that are shooting completely different angles, it's right now, and it should be interesting to see what is going to develop.
Savas gets his 7th in and his spare. Now, Top Star Bowling is sanctioned by the American Bowling Congress. The lanes here at Marlboro, which is a 24-lane Brunswick house, is the lanes are sanctioned by the ABC. Thoroughly checked. The conditions are very normal. Right over the first arrow is Billy G, and he pops a double in there. Now, he has won 4 times. He defeated Al Thompson, Chuck Wagner, Don Carter, and last week, Dean Cortade, and he has a high series of 686. He has averaged 212 in his 4 appearances. And that starts with 3 in a row. And what is his high game, Whitey?
239, Jack, and the way he's going now, why, he's pointing to perhaps knocking that off, too. And with a little... And as I look back more on my statistics, I see that it's 258. If you remember, he shot that on his last game last week.
Now, that was a typical Savas ball, and you can't say that he was fortunate or lucky with that hit, because that's the sort of a strike he counts on getting. Al Savas, gunning for the victory. Gunning for the high game and the high series as well. And there he is. I mentioned during the introduction, 89 sanctioned 300 games. Now, that's an awful lot of official 300 games.
Yes, that applies to a tournament, Jack, or league play in which the American Bowling Congress has a sanction on that particular event.
Way out. We saw this last week. When Billy G does not pile into that pocket, when he gets a thin hit, he seldom carries. And at the same time, when he's high, he doesn't get many getaways. In other words, he's not going to get much help from the ball unless he is right in that pocket. Now he shoots the spare in a much different fashion as he gets the spare. So he started with three and then a spare in the fourth. Savas started with a strike, then a spare, then a double. Billy G has had two sanctioned 300 games. He has had a high series of 826. See? That's what I was talking about. I don't want to be, and I told you so, but that was, that's a pretty good example of what I was talking about. When he was just a fraction high, he failed to carry.
Yes, that ball rides high, Jack, and will leave a four pin. And sometimes on a hit like that, it'll leave the seven with it, a 4-7.
So he has 95 through the fourth with a spare. It's a bit warm here. And because of the lights necessary, you'll see Al Savas mopping his brow quite a bit. He labors hard. Gets that ball out, turns it over. And a little getaway as he leaves a 6-10. So he was working on a double looking for three. He's down a few pins here in the early going as a result of the three-bagger by Golembiewski. Hey. Yeah, he came back shaking his head. I knew it. I knew I had done it.
Jack, they seem to feel that. I know a lot of bowlers do, that when you release that ball and it chops, I don't know, it's just something that causes you to know you're going to get it.
Billy G has 95 through the fourth with a spare. Al Savas opened in the fifth, and he has 96. Trying to get back on a strike. And back in there. There's one thing about it. The defender here on this Top Star Bowling Series has to be a bit more relaxed, Whitey. For example, Billy here has won four times. He's already assured of $4,500. The other guy's pressing. That's good deal more so.
Well, like it is called, Jack, King of the Hill, and that's what it applies to. This guy's standing at the top of the hill like the old kids game, and you want to try to knock him down. And the only way you can knock him down is get strikes.
Even if he were to lose here, it's conceivable that Golembiewski could win $6,000. $4,000 for winning, $500 for losing on this one, plus the other $2,500. But he wants even more than that. With a double. And Al Savas, already behind in the match, possessor of the only open, has a strike going, bowling in the seventh. Boy, he's got a fine ball and a good angle going for him, and he doubles. To stay with him, he's 19 pins behind right at the moment. Who's going to make good use of this double? we shall see in the eighth round. Al is a member of the Brunswick Advisory Staff of Champions. It's won a host of titles. That's three in a row.
Jack, I've been just figuring that out. Actually, the total amount of money that Billy would win if he loses $7,000.
If he loses on this one?
Yeah.
He's way out. You could tell that he was going to be shy of the head pin. And he failed to get the three-bagger, so Savas gets back some of that deficit. It was 2-4-5 has proved treacherous over the weeks to the various performers. There's that five pin. There's so many ways to miss that one, Whitey, and that's one of them.
Well, I think with the type ball that Billy's throwing, and he's got this thing where it's going so straight that there was no chance that ball would hook, and that's what happened. He just chopped it off. He didn't get the break where it goes to the left of the two pin.
Left himself no margin for error, so he opens in the eighth. There's 170. He's in the ninth frame, and back on one. We've got a good match here. I know you're enjoying it because two very fine performers, great personalities in this world of bowling. His lead is cut now to five pins, and we shall have a new leader in this game if Savas can pop one more here in the ninth frame. He opened in the fifth, and he put together three straight strikes. Is that four? They got to go down. You know, why do you talk about, we talk about 10-pin taps and eight tens and a bad break on a seven pin. When you hit him like that, with that, the way that ball is rolling, with that angle, in the pocket, that squarely, there's nothing can stand up.
That's true, Jack, and that's why they do carry, say, 99% of those hits. It's when that unbelievable tap comes in there that's hard to explain what happens. Pins just mix, that's all.
Here's the 10th frame for him. And a big one. We're going to have a new leader here at the end of the first game. Mr. Savas coming along with fire in his eyes. And that opened, let me see, he's got eight strikes. He came up with a 6-10. What was that that he, he chopped the six off the 10, that's right. And he's got room for two more strikes in this game. Well, that wasn't a bad spot for that. It could have come at a more inopportune moment. So he'll go for the count now and go for the two pins. And he can end with 232. Pretty good beginning, huh?
That's about the best start anyone's had against Billy G.
How is he doing?
I don't know if he can explain it himself. I can't, Jack. It looked like the ball just got away from him and just went right off into the gutter.
I'm sure he wasn't trying. He wasn't trying to pick that split.
I don't think so. I think it'd be interesting to ask him. We better try to remember that.
Ends with 230 nonetheless. And Billy G couldn't do anything about that. He was looking for the double.
If he would have got them all, Jack, we'd have had a tie game. Yeah. And what a tie game, 230. Yeah.
That's right. But now Al Savas is going to be out in front. Highest that Billy can score now is 210. Came pretty close, didn't it?
I think he knew it, too, the way they were measuring him and then coming back, looking up at the eyes.
He is shooting his spares in a different fashion than he is shooting strikes with regard to the roll of the ball.
I think he's lifting the ball a little bit more on the spares, Jack. Anyway, there to allow for that ball to curve out over the channel.
209, huh? 209 for Billy G and Al Savas with 230 at the end of the first game. .230 to .209 at the end of the first game here on Top Star Bowling, and you see how these professionals react to adversity out here. After Al came up with that open in the fifth frame, that's when he went to work, and I'm sure you'll see Something of the same from Billy G, who finds himself on the short end of the score after being a winner here for four consecutive weeks. Bob Strampy is standing by in the wings to be the opponent next week for the winner of this week's Top Star Bowling. Let's see what happens in the second game. Now that important first frame, and important from a lot of viewpoints. One out in front, he could dishearten his opponent just a bit by popping one in there to get the good start in the second game. And the 5-7 for a moment, seven pin remains. Now that advantage swings to the other fellow, Billy Golembiewski, who finds himself down by 21 pins. He could run up the warning signal with a big X in the first frame. Reaching way up. Oftentimes, it's difficult to discern the size of the athletes. Billy here is 5'8 and a half, weighs 135. Rather slight fellow. Savas is 6 foot, 165. So the best each can do is a spare in the first frame. Mentioned Bob Strampy a while ago. Why do you want about him?
Well, Bob is actually from the area up around Minneapolis and St. Paul. That's where he accomplished most of his records and everything. And he's one of those travelers on the professional bowlers tour. He's been able to do quite well. Good 200 average bowler.
His style is a lot like Savas, isn't it?
Yes, come to think
of
it, he is.
They're much the same size.
And like each time we try to pass on to the viewers, none of these bowlers rush the foul line. I think here's a good example of two bowlers we have out here now.
There's the first strike in the second game. With regard to the rushers, Whitey, maybe Harry Smith would come about the closest, huh, the way he reels up there?
Yes, and what I think gives the impression that he goes faster, Jack, is he has that distinct weave in there.
But he's not really going up.
I don't think so.
Now, Savas. Four-step approach, way out, and he strikes, stays right with him. He's really spread out there at the foul line, isn't he? He's left arm out one way and the right hand out the other.
Yeah, he has the record of after he gets a few strikes, he's one of them that starts running them out, so I see him going all over the place, too.
He's a real favorite in Milwaukee. Has quite an outstanding record, of which I'll tell you after this. After that double. Al Savas is the record holder for the highest average in BPAA team match game tournament. Bowl 234 average. Billy disputes something that I had said earlier, that he wasn't going to get any strikes that he probably shouldn't carry, because he got one that time.
I think when Billy got that strike, I don't know if he's been hearing us, but he looked back at that young lady that we've been trying to guess who it is, and he raised his eyebrows too, but I think it was mainly at the strike, not at her.
See, now there's a thin hit, and he leaves a four pin. That gal is here at every one of the matches in Top Star Bowling, and always in that same location.
And I've never seen her actually take sides with either one of the opponents. You know, you think she'd be applauding or cheering for
one of
the
other. Not very animated, but about everything else. Billy G going for the spare after the double. He spares in the fourth frame. Now Al Savas to work again. He started with a spare, then a double, and a chance to increase his lead, which was 21 pins at the outset, with a hit right here. He knew that was coming. It didn't surprise him one bit. 6-7-10. So instead of increasing his lead, he loses about half of it.
And Jack, to shoot at this, why Al will stand way over to the left. In fact, his leg is against that return. He'll go across the lane and try to put it out on there.
He missed this in the roll-off of the first game. Now he goes for the count, and he gets the two pins. I wonder if he'll be looking back at those two pins that he missed in the 10th frame of the first game. Maybe, because I don't think this one's going to be over early.
No, I think this is a bad break here, getting that split. He must come up with a strike now here, Jack.
He didn't think he deserved that. You can just about read the score from watching his face when he comes back.
Well, if you remember, we were just talking about it. I think it was Billy in the fifth frame on the same lane left the four pin, and we recounted that you do sometimes get the 4-7 on that particular hit.
So he's fair, so now Billy G can gain an advantage here with a strike in the fifth frame of the second game. Billy from Detroit. Won an awful lot of honors over the years.
He gave up on that ball, Jack, but yet it kept coming, and he got a loose hit, and those pins were flying all over the place.
That gives him 89 through the fourth. He's continuing to do all he can to refute what I said about being unable to carry those thin hits, because he's been popping them in, but I'm sure the people saw him give up on that. He was looking down at his position at the foul line. And no four pin this time. He's picked up 14 of those pins by which he trailed. Had a chance to pick up 10 more of them, but he didn't. So the difference in the match is only seven pins, with Al Savas out in front here at the end of the fifth frame of the second game. Billy G on the spare. Ball didn't move much for him. It appeared he was almost ready to back up.
I think, Jack, from him, the way he's throwing that first ball, and of course these bowlers try to throw the ball the same way. Second ball, just like the first, and I think that's why that ball just straightened out a bit.
Al has a spare working. Almost had the 7-10. Oftentimes, bowlers go on from breaks like that to better things. He's lost 15 pins so far in this game. Ahead by six. They each have a spare in the sixth. Only a six-pin difference. More than halfway through our match. Three strikes in this game for Billy, who had six in the first game. Only two for Al, who had eight strikes in the first game.
Jack, they're both throwing the crown jewel bowling ball.
Allie a red one and Billy a blue one. And he comes back saying, why can't I do that every time? Billy G has 109 through the fifth with a spare up. Al Savas 114 through the sixth with a strike. Al Savas has a strike in the seventh frame. Now Billy G is up in the seventh with a spare working. Way outside. First out. He rooted 9/10 of them down. He was really rooting up there at the foul line. He turned sideways like a drum major. Orchestra conductor. But one sour note, 10-pin. Billy has won many honors, as we told you. Bowling Magazine All-American Team, the Bowler's Journal All-American, National Bowling Illustrated All-American. Over the years, one of the best.
Jack, a lot of these honors have been given to these bowlers, and they've been very helpful to them, and the Bowling Writers of America have been responsible for raising bowlers to the stature they are. And I see in the audience here Johnny Archibald, who is one of the outstanding bowler writers of the nation.
With the Post-Dispatch here in St. Louis. There's the strike for Bill. The ball right straight into the pocket is eighth frame strike, giving him 148 through the seventh. Al Savas leading by six pins, but with an opportunity to make use of the strike he has working. What a hit. What a hit. That's what he wanted. He You know, oftentimes, at the close of the show, and you've seen quite a few of these bowling programs, they're handed checks for $500 or $1,000 or even more money when they win the additional prizes. And it may seem that they lack enthusiasm, but this is where they expend all of their energy, right up here. They appreciate that money. They're working hard for it, and this is where you watch the labor going on. This is the way they make a living. Like that. Most all of these bowlers whom you see, that's three in a row for Savas, whom you see on Top Star Bowling do nothing else for a living but bowl in these various tournaments. When they're not hitting, boy, why, it's a tough life. When they earn the money, they figure that they have earned it. That ball, he drilled that one right at the... That's really what you call drilling a ball.
Yes, and Jack, on the Brunswick pin finder, he defines the pins a 3-6-10-9.
How does he want to shoot this?
Jack, he'll stand to the left and go across the lane. He has to hit that real good. I mean, this is a tough spare to shoot at.
He has to take the 3-9 out with the ball and cover the 6, and he did it nicely. That one could have hurt him. So he spares in the ninth, goes into the 10th frame. Savas has 3 working. Yeah, that's pretty far ahead now. Could go into a 234 game. Billy, 218. Look at that 6 pin lying there. So the best we can do is spare. 2, 3, 4 strikes, which wouldn't be too good ordinarily, but his opponent, Savas, now has 5 and has a string going. He's about 38 pins ahead. Billy spares. Right. We'll give him 207 on the heels of a 209 production. No opens in this game for Billy G. Savas had a split but came back from it. He gets them all, and 207, 209, 207, 416, Billy G. Savas could really tack on some pins here. He could be 48 pins ahead if he cracks 3 of them in here.
Not only that, Jack, he's dreaming right for that big prize, too, on high series.
Come on back, Al. Come back. He kept walking.
You know, I think I hear, you know, how people get behind these bowlers. I think that there's a member of Al's nationality over here, and every once in a while he gives out with some Greek.
Savas trying for his second strike now in the 10th frame, looking for his 5th in a row.
Thank you!
And no 10. So there are 10 there that Billy G will not have to shoot at in the 3rd game. Brings us back for 223 and 453. 686 is the high series. 223. So Billy G has a total of 416 and Al Savas a total of 453 at the end of the 2nd game. Before the 3rd game here at Marlboro Lanes, we ordinarily chat with a guest. And our guest is Mr. Louis Kitlaus, who is the Director of Physical Education and Athletic Director for the St. Louis Public School System. That's and correct. Bowling plays a part in that, right, Louis?
That's right. We have bowling done by the students in school, after school, in a recreational sort of a way.
Isn't an organized event?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there are many of the activities, many of the children, they're bowling in leagues after school. And sponsored by teachers who are members of the faculty.
How about the teachers' leagues? Do they get together?
Yeah, surprising enough, we have there was a men's club, and they had bowling after school. And interesting enough, at one time, in connection with our recreational program, it was during the summer, We had our playground mothers who bowled, and this was a thing.
Oh, yeah,
and
you had a big tournament.
That's right.
At the end of the year. I'm familiar with that.
That's right.
Now, the bowling on the part of these students, is it a serious thing or just organized recreation?
Well, to those who take it, who do it, take it real seriously. All kinds of competition is taken seriously.
Are there things to be learned from it, such as concentration, help in the schoolwork?
We think so. We think so. We think that there's a great deal that they can get in that direction, Jerry.
I know that you coached football at a St. Louis high school, and the kids used to sneak away to bowl sometimes.
Yeah, when we first opened up the Southwest High School, right across the street, their bowling alley, our way alley, they had quite an extensive program, and a lot of our students bowled over there, both boys and girls, and it's still going on, and this has been 25 years ago.
And it has a good carryover effect. This is something they can do when they no longer participate in football
That's
or baseball.
Right. That's right. In this respect, I think it makes its greatest contribution. I think that there are some activities that are done in the athletic program that they cannot do after they leave school. Bowling, golf, tennis, these are things that they can do for a long time after they leave school.
But not quite as well as what we're watching here.
No, this is amazing to me to see this kind of bowling. I've never seen it before to this extent. But
I think they'll amaze us a bit more.
Well, that's right.
Thanks a lot for the business.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
All right, so. Yeah. This? Mr. Kitlaus, who is our guest, and now let's see what Al Savas and Billy Golembiewski have in store for us as the third game gets underway. The perm difference is 37, and this bowler is on the short end. Got a break, but not good enough break to get a good strike. Leaves a two-pin. Billy G from Detroit has won four times, defeated Al Thompson, Chuck Wagner, Don Carter, and Cortade. And now gets a spare.
Team Cortade.
A while ago, Whitey talked about France. Talking about John Archibald, the writer is in our audience. Right behind him is Frantz Lox, a familiar name in sports. Sports announcer. He's done a lot for the sport of bowling around this area. And also, Ruth's trying to get on a strike. Whoops. And a little getaway right there. Leaves a 3-6-9. And we talked earlier when Billy G had it. And he actually had the 3-6-9-10 in the ninth frame of the second game, that this is rather precarious. Have to take the 3-9 with the ball going straight through and also cover the 6-pin. Like that. So each a spare. No change in the lead of 37 enjoyed by Al Savas as he goes for the $1,000 here on Top Star Bowling at the Marlboro Lanes. Right on Route 66, just outside of St. Louis.
Al is a movement to where he looks down on the approach jack before he starts.
And the four pin remains. With a 453 at the end of two games, Al has a chance at the high series, 686, owned by his opponent in this match, Billy G. About a 240 or something less to beat him. Two spares for him.
I recall in weeks gone by, Jack, when Billy commented on whether he would go on the defensive at close. I think right now he's, once he gets those strikes, and as many as possible.
And as quickly as possible. There's one. Beautifully in there. Now Bill moves over to 21. I don't think the two lanes have made much difference to either of these bowlers.
No, I think they've good expression, Jack. We've read them real good, really, the way they're playing.
And a four pin remains. He needed that one. As each frame goes by, we get closer and closer to a new king of the hill here on Top Star Bowling. Billy, the only one with a strike thus far in the third game, but couldn't double. Now the Milwaukee to the line.
Al's style is unusual, Jack. We see him when he gets up on the approach, and he'll hold the ball in a swing to be right at his knees, giving it a slight push forward.
There he is. Now, I know I've mentioned it numerous times. Let me say it again. Billy G has won for the past 4 weeks. Savas has other ideas. Looking for a double here in the fourth frame. Leaves the bucket on a thin hit. 2-4-5-8.
Jack, it isn't that these pros can't pick spares, but you see, they only shoot at majority times at single pins and then at two pins. And when they get a cluster like that, like they have out here, like Al has, he has just as much trouble as an average bowler.
Oh, break that time, didn't he? Yeah. Came back. Came back and got that 8-pin.
See
and
that?
And those rooting for Golembiewski say, you lucky thing. And the others say, nice going, Al.
That's what I meant by, you know, how he has trouble with that particular spare.
Billy's going to make him work. He left a 2-pin over here on 21 in the first frame, and then a 4-pin. Let's see if he can hit it this time for a double. He's 36 pins behind. He's 26 pins behind. That's a double. Now he'll get back on the other lane the next time where he's been really popping them in. Al Savas bowled 230, 223. Has 59 through the third with a spare. Has had only one strike in this game. Billy, the double may not do you any good. Billy G has 60 through the third with a double. Al Savas has 79 through the fourth with a strike. Six tens ahead, is Savas. You'd better hit one right here. Part of that 26 could disappear in a hurry when his foe gets up there. There's a double. Seemed for a while like that 8-pin was almost rooted there.
Yeah, the ball stuck in there strong, Jack, but he took it out. Boy, this could get really tight.
Billy G looking for three. He's just got to keep hitting. Like that. So away goes more of that lead. Right at the moment, 26 goes down to 10, theoretically speaking. I say theoretically because Savas could get it right back up there with his own three-bagger, but in that respect, Billy G is a frame ahead. They've each bowled through the sixth. Now we start the seventh. He's got to keep going. He's inside that arrow. 4-6. You could see it coming, Whitey. He just missed the mark.
It's right in the bugle that time, Jack, and that's what you get when you hit in the nose, that 4-6.
Especially with throwing the ball as straight as he's throwing it.
Yes, there was no chance for that ball to break to the left there, and it wasn't because of the lane conditions. It was just the way Billy's throwing the ball.
After Savas had a comment for him, I know not what it was. That's an open for Billy. Savas can really smack him down with a hit right here. That's three in a row for him. Three in a row. Now we're getting into higher mathematics with regard to the scoring because Savas started 37 pins ahead. He has added to that. We'll figure it after this. See, there's the difference. Now, he had that hit right on the nose that Billy G had. But his ball was hooking and working more than Bill's. So Bill came up with a 4-6, and Savas gets away and leaves a 6-10. He's about 48 pins ahead. He brings this back. That's what he is, 48 pins ahead. There's room for the defending champion here. Bill could go on to a 236. Of course, Savas would only have to mark then in order to win. He's going to give it a whirl. There's one in the eighth. This ninth frame will be very interesting when Al Savas gets up there, particularly if Bill gets a double. No double. Leaves a two pin.
I think we're reaching the point, Jack, where Billy needed to go all the way there, and even if to the point of Al getting one open, but...
I think Al could afford one open in the two remaining frames and still win.
I don't think at this stage that he will, but you never can tell in this game. And if he does go all the way, Jack, he would have a 237, and when we figured it out, that makes a 690.
Yeah, well, now he's got to get three in order to beat the high series, and you can bet that Billy G is figuring that out, too, because he's the defending champion in that high series business with a 686. Savas has to get three now for 690 to rank number one in that department for a chance at the $1,500.
It still would leave Billy with the high game of 258, Jack, for that $1,000.
And no 10 pins, so Golembiewski is safe in both of those departments, and you don't think those two were mulling over the figures while you're wrong. It's amazing how proficient they become at arithmetic when they get into this bowling and start going for the money. There's the spare for Savas. 217 with a hit. And that would be 670, six pins shy of the series. And an eight count and a good spot for that. 215. 668. And so Al Savas is going to be the new winner, but let's see how Billy G goes out. There's one, giving him 186 through the ninth. 216 if he hits two more. Billy had 209, 207. Could total 632. There's another hit. He averaged 212 up until this session. And he's right there again, just four pins below that for these three games. Bill ends with two.
Tied.
215. 215 for each in this last game. And Al Savas, the new winner here on Top Star Bowling. 668 to 631 for Billy Golembiewski. Another Top Star Bowling match is over for this week. Listen, you men bowl so rapidly, we have a little time left. You feel energetic for about 3 minutes, see how many strikes you can get?
Sure enough.
Give you a chance to get ready for Bob Strampy next week, so you can experiment a little more now, and it won't cost you anything.
Do they count?
No, they don't count.
Oh, no.
We'll give you 3 minutes, and we'll start the buzzer, you see how many strikes you can get, Anything goes out here. You can interfere with each other as much as we don't hurt each other.
My chance to get even with them.
My chance to... Whitey Harris and I have been talking about the Brunswick A2 automatic pin setter and the rapidity with which the ball is returned. You better get set. We'll let that buzzer go. Fire away. There it is. Hey, Bill. There's that light hit you were talking about, huh? Now show us what happened when you went punched down the nose, all right? What's happening? He didn't bother you, did he? And Al Savas, what happened there? You were expecting something, huh? Now that was a high hit, huh? He's in a groove. Each has delivered three times. That ball fit? Got the wrong ball. We have a minute and a half left. It isn't very often that these bowlers get to fool around out here in the lanes. It's usually all serious business. Fellas throw a lot of strikes. He's had three strikes out of five frames. 2 minutes gone by. He's a frame ahead of you, Al. Give him the towel, Bill. Wait till he's ready. Don't punch that rack, Al. Hey, Bill, it's going down again. Half a minute left. And that's seven frames for each in 2 minutes and 45 seconds. This will probably be your last delivery. You have plenty of time. That's the way to run it out, Bill. That's the way to finish. He couldn't match it. And only a couple of seconds left, and that will be it. And the bowlers each went through eight frames in our rapid-fire delivery. We'll be back to talk further with the bowlers and award the prize money here on Top Star Bowling in a moment. Time to give out with the money here on Top Star Bowling, and each week we have a young lady who is a graduate from the John Robert Powers School of Modeling and the Pat Allen Agency here in St. Louis to award the prize money. Candy Tolles is the young lady's name this week. Candy?
Here's your $500 check, Billy G. Sorry that you are losing this time. We were very glad to have you so long.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Here's your $1,000 check.
Thank you, Candy.
Thank you very much, Candy. Candy Tolles. Bill, you still have the high series going.
In the high game, I was a little bit afraid there for a while. Al needed a double and eight pins, and I said, I'll not only lose that, but I'll lose the high game and high series.
We knew you were figuring it out, and we saw you giving that look when you came back, when you failed to hit again.
I left that 10-pin there, and that kind of locked it up for him for another week anyway.
Mm-hmm. For another week, he's always
got a chance, I or someone else. So he's got a few weeks to sweat out.
So you've won 4,500 and you've got 2,500 going, and it could be 7,000.
Well, that's what I call, I hope it holds up.
Worthwhile.
That's
right.
Been
really fun to have you here, Bill.
Thank you very much, Jack. I certainly enjoyed it.
Good luck to you. Billy Golembiewski. Couple of Northerners next week. Al here is from Milwaukee, and Bob Strampy from Minneapolis will be your opponent. He'll be a good one.
Yes, he will be. I bowled him on Top Star Bowling last year.
What happened?
I was fortunate enough to beat him. I hope I can repeat, but I think he's out for a little revenge.
How many did you win last year?
I won two, lost a third.
Uh-huh. Well, we'll see what happens next week, Al.
Fine.
See you
Thank
back
you,
here
sir.
At Marlboro.
Fine, I'll be happy to get back.
Al Savas. Two of the very best, and I know you enjoyed watching them, from the Marlboro Lanes, located in the village of Marlboro, just outside the city of St. Louis on Route 66. Tune in next week, will you? It'll be Al Savas and Bob Strampy. That'll be another good one. Now we speak for Whitey Harris as we say thanks for your time this time. Till next time, so long. Top Star Bowling has been presented by... equipment by Brunswick, the number one name in bowling. Top Star Bowling is sanctioned by the American Bowling Congress.